Dear Diary, nothing ever happens.
In your power, all the same.
John, we're always adding up numbers, and we still never have any money.
If it hadn't been so cold last winter, we would have come out ahead this year.
You children are supposed to be sleeping. Now stop playing. Cassandra, turn off your light.
Mom, I'm still writing.
Lights off. Now. Come on. Snuggle up. Here we go. Sleep tight.
I first saw my American cousin in the golden summer of 1959.
What is it, man? Speak up.
Oh, yes, sir. Uncle John? I'm Butch Walker.
From California?
Oh, of course, Al's boy. Well, what a surprise. Are Al and Dolly with you?
No, sir. I'm up here alone. On vacation.
Oh. Well, you're welcome to stay here, son. Now, please turn that damn radio and those lights off. You'll wake up the whole household.
What's going on?
It's Al and Dolly's boy, Butch. Alone on vacation. Were you expecting it?
Well, no one's written to me about it. Then there are a whole lot of things that no one bothers to tell me.
Hello, Aunt Kitty. I'm sorry if I got you up.
Well, you can sleep in the spare room. Perhaps you can help pick cherries.
Glad to help out.
You're not in trouble with the police, are you?
Oh, no, sir.
You could tell me if you are.
No, sir, I'm not.
Good. You haven't got a girl in trouble, have you? Funny, I was just thinking about your father. His parents sent him up here one summer. What a summer that was. He fell in love with Carol Butterfield, and I was going with Gladys French. Did he ever mention Carol Butterfield?
No, sir.
Well, that was a long time ago. Good night, Dad.
Night, sir.
Good night, Dad. Are you really from California?
You bet. I drove up here yesterday.
Are you gonna stay with us?
For a little while.
Can I take your picture?
Sure.
Okay, that's great. All right.
Wow!
Eddie, get out of here.
I'll go fly a kite. What kind of car is this?
Cadillac.
Thanks,
all the wrong grits. Saw a picture with the magazine.
I'll try again.
Come on, get in.
Everybody smile.
Morning, Butch. That's quite a car you've got there, son.
Yeah,
My ma gave it to
me. Dad, can you take a picture of me and Butch?
Oh, very well.
All right, you guys, get lost.
What?
You're Sandy, right?
Yeah.
Well, Sandy, I'm your cousin Butch. I'm very pleased to meet you.
I'm very pleased to meet you, too.
Why? Quite an extravagant car for one so young. It's so, American.
Now, Kitty, comes from a good family. Americans, of course, but still a fairly decent family.
Mm-hmm. Now, smile. There you go.
Hey, can I take a picture of you all together? Here to send back home to my folks?
Oh, sure. Well, why not?
All right.
Uh-huh. Oh, off.
Watch the car.
Yes.
Okay, everybody, look this way. Smile. Got it.
Great.
Danny and Eddie, come along now. Butch, it's time to get up to the orchard.
Okay, come on, girls.
Sandra, we've got lots of cherries to can this morning.
Come on, Mom, can I stay outside a little while longer?
No, I need you in the kitchen. Let's go.
Started going out on dates?
Not until I went away to McGill. I went out with a boy from Trinidad. He was in my contemporary English literature class.
You mean you never went out till they shipped you off to university?
I was not shipped off. Back to work.
Gas still need some help?
If you didn't go out on dates, what did you do?
Well, your Aunt Lyd and I were always putting on plays.
Oh, come on, that's so dumb.
Sandra, sometimes you really are the most unpleasant child I could ever imagine.
I am not a child.
You most certainly are. You are the most selfish, self-centered...
I know. Selfish, self-centered, silly, sloppy, cheap. Let's not forget that old favorite, inconsiderate. Let me see, did I forget any?
That's it. That is really it. If you can't say anything nice, don't say anything
at all.
Get out. Get out!
I'm gone. One of these days I'll just run away, and you'll be sorry.
Go right ahead.
Boxes, Butch?
Sir. Two so far.
I see. How many boxes, Lenny?
Eight, sir.
Oh, very good. How many boxes, Daniel?
Six and a half, Major.
Mucker?
Seven and a half, sir.
Good work. Keep it up. Eight more rows to go. Why aren't you helping your mother?
Told me to get out again.
I wish you two would stop fighting.
She picks on me.
Well, your mother grew up in a quiet house, and she always thought she was going to be a librarian, so you must try to understand that she's... Well, that she's not... It's just that you children are a bit much for her sometimes.
I'm not a child.
Oh, yes, you are. Exactly how old are you, anyway? I lose track of you all.
Oh, really, Dad? I'll be 13 in 3 months. practically a teenager.
Really? Teenager? Oh, dear. Well, perhaps you should come with me today. I think we should have a little talk.
Okay, Dad. I wasn't doing anything anyway.
Feet down, Sandra.
Well, I know two cherries on this ranch we won't be picking. One's green and the other's rotten.
Oh, hi, Cheryl. Glad you made it.
Hey, does this mean Rosie's here, too?
Uh-huh. Except she's waiting in the car. Afraid of rattlesnakes.
Want one?
Rattlesnakes?
I think the time has come for me to talk to you about, males and females together. I'm afraid it's a very complicated bit of business.
Yeah, I know. Me and Thelma and Sue and Lizzie talk about it all the time.
Oh, see? As I was saying, the attraction between male and female is natural and necessary for the continuation of the species. The female excites the male, and once it's excited, the male is overcome by uncontrollable urges.
Uncontrollable urges?
They're rather difficult to explain. You can see it when a bull knows there's a cow nearby. That bull will break through fences, barn doors, walls, anything that stands between him and that cow.
You mean you were like that with Mum?
No, of course not. Well, not exactly.
Sounds complicated, Dad.
Yes, it is. Well, it's good to have a chance to talk with you like this.
Another Bicky?
No, thank you.
Tea, Sandra?
No, thanks, Granny. I think I'll just have a glass of water.
Water? What on God's great earth is water?
Water? From the tap? In the lake? Falls from the sky?
Gracious. You mean water. Now, let me please hear you say water as it is meant to be spoken.
Water!
Very good. That wasn't difficult, was it? What these young children do, the Queen's language makes me shudder.
Hi, Sue. Yeah, it's me, Sandy. Listen, we got this American cousin staying with us. Yeah. California. Honest. He's way cuter than Barry Bent. I'm not joking. His car is so fabulous. I've never seen anything like it. No joke. I'm gonna get him to take us for a car ride. Sue? I gotta go. Talk to you last.
Sandra, are you joining us? She has no manners.
I don't want you hanging around the pickers while they're working. Go and see if you can help your mother.
All she does is yell at me.
Where's Jim June?
One of these days I'll run away. I'll just get out of here. No note or anything. And they'll be sorry. And they'll wish they were nicer to me. Maybe I'll leave a short.
Hi.
Hi.
So, what's going on?
Nothing.
Is somebody buried here?
Yeah, our great-grandfather.
Nice view.
It's okay. They only play rock and roll on Saturday afternoons.
You're kidding. In the States, we got rock and roll all day long.
Well, that'd be the most.
Yeah, it's okay. I saw you getting mad at your dad.
Treat me like a child.
How old are you?
Yes.
I'd say about 14, 15.
Can I have a ride in your car?
Why not?
When?
I don't know. I'm supposed to be picking cherries. Hey, but those ladders are dangerous. A guy could hurt himself on one of those things.
Yeah, Picker broke his leg last year. His dad ever mad.
So, how old did you say you were?
I never said.
Chicks. You're 14, right?
Nope. I'm 12.
Oh, man. You're talking to some kid.
What's your cousin like?
Here it comes.
Well, it's kind of hard to say. I think he's pretty conceited and a little immature. Does he have a girlfriend? That him? Don't get up. Why not? Hi, Butch.
Hey, Johnny. You looking after these girls?
Yeah, I am, Butch.
Sandy, aren't you going to introduce us?
Where's Lenny and Mucker?
Still picking. Sandy.
Shirley, this is my American cousin Butch, and that's Rosie Hardman. I'm gonna go jump in the lake.
Good idea. Well, Shirley, I'm very pleased to meet you.
Staying long?
Maybe. I'm up here on a vacation.
Well, maybe not completely dead. Maybe just 16 at someplace else.
Ma. Got it.
Great. There goes Sandy's mom.
Hey, Johnny, I'll take you up to the house here.
Okay. Hey, I'll give you a hand.
Thanks, Butch.
I want copies of that, okay?
Okay.
Hey, is this your tent?
No, that's Lenny's.
Uh-huh. Hey, there's lots of room in here. Why don't you come in, Cheryl? It's real cool.
No, I shouldn't.
Oh, come on. It won't bite you.
Okay, but only a minute.
Shirley, do you believe in love at first sight?
I don't know, I'm going steady.
As soon as I saw you, I just got this feeling.
Well, I bet you say that to all the girls you meet.
Oh, brother.
Shirley, Shirley, Shirley.
Yeah. Speed.
drive it all the way to town and get my nose fixed.
You want the sugar on that?
Here, Butch,
yeah,
take this
over here.
Yeah?
Okay. Sandra, so glad you decided to join us. I baked your favorite cake. See?
It's good, Mom.
Thanks, Paul. Sandra, would you also get some news for Johnny?
Sure, it's a beautiful place.
It's almost impossible to think of living anywhere else.
It's a real shame to have to sell it.
Sandra, could you help me with my lines after supper?
Well, that's right. Okay. You're playing the little theater, don't you, Kitty?
That's right. We're always looking for new members, Jim.
Now, Catherine.
Oh, he might enjoy it, John.
Man, he's got the greatest rod. It's got a 409, and it can lay rubber till smoke clouds the whole street. See him go.
Well, that's a fancy car you got there, Butch. What the hell type is that, anyway?
El Dorado, Baritz.
It's a Cadillac, then?
Yep.
Oh, must cost a pretty penny. I bet the girls are impressed, eh?
Yeah, well, that goes without saying.
Yeah, I can imagine.
The cops have just caught you racing that car?
Nah, they'll never catch me.
Yeah. We should go for a ride in it, eh?
Yeah, maybe. We'll see.
Yeah. Did you see mine up there?
That old Buick?
Yeah. 57 special.
Fastest thing in town.
Oh, yeah.
I'll have to see about that.
From now on, you have a hold over me.
From now on, you have a hold over me.
My dearest Hedda, believe me, I shall not abuse the position.
In your power, all the same. At the mercy of your will and demand. And so, a slave. A slave. No, that thought I cannot tolerate. Never. I can hear perfectly well what you are saying. But how am I going to get through the evenings out here? Now, Sandra, please make sure that Ruth and Pixie get to bed on time. And I don't want you hanging around those pickers.
Okay. We shall have a very pleasant time together here, you and I.
Yes. That is what you're looking forward to, isn't it, Mr. Brack? You as the only cock in the yard.
Shot herself! Shot herself in the temple! Think of it! But merciful God, one doesn't do that kind of thing.
Bye, Sandra. Don't forget to put away the laundry. Tell your father I'm gone. Be back around 10.
Bye, Mom. Break a leg. Knock him dead.
I'm afraid he doesn't want to do the shawl.
Well, John, what did Jim say? What actual damage has been done to the trees?
Hi, Butch. How's it going, cuz? Can I have a ride in your car today? How about tomorrow? Maybe the day after?
Well, we've got 6 growing children to consider in all of this, and they're growing up very quickly.
I know. They're the ones I'm thinking about. I grew up here, and I'm going to go here, too. But I don't want to worry you about all this.
But, John, we must face reality. We simply cannot go on like this.
About going to town. I thought you might like to come, but I see you got right.
No, I'm sorry.
You.
What am I gonna do? But there ain't no cure for the sun.
Cadillac. Now you can't use the car because you didn't work with it.
Hey, don't tell your dad we got this candy, okay? Get in.
My grandmother says the boy is supposed to open the door.
Oh, really?
Yes, really.
Here. Get in if you want to ride.
Thank you, Butch. Girls like to be treated with respect.
Tell me about it.
Is she really gonna get in trouble?
I think so. Let's go for a swim.
Okay, I'm hot.
Oh, Luke is there.
Hi, Shirley. Hi, Lenny.
Hey, Butch. Don't do anything I wouldn't do.
He's got a fancy car, but he sure isn't a cherry picker. I bet he hasn't worked a day in his life.
He thinks he's really hot in that car.
Yeah, will Johnny ever walk again?
I don't think so.
What happened to him?
I don't know. He's just always been like that. I think it was the birth.
The birth?
Yeah, they had to use forceps.
Oh, God, that's horrible.
Yeah. He told me in his dreams
he'd walk. Wow. Back in the States, we don't got roads like this. Everything's paved.
Yeah? Like living in the States?
Are you kidding? Of course I like it. Anything you want, we got it in the USA.
So what are you doing up here in Canada? I got tickets to moving, baby, I ain't lying. My heart is beating rhythm and it's right on time. So be my guest, you got nothing to lose. Won't you let me take you on the sea cruise? Ooh-wee, ooh-wee, baby.
Why don't you just sit back and enjoy the scenery, huh?
Scenery? The scenery is boring. I've seen it all before a million times.
Well, see it some more.
Besides, I want to know why you ran away from home. Well?
Well, what?
Well, why did you run away from home?
Who says I did? Anyways, it's none of your business, okay?
I'm considering it myself.
What? Are you retarded? Girls don't run away from home. Not unless they're tramps or something. It's too tough for a girl.
Girls never get to do anything.
You are some crazy chick. You know that? Tell you what.
Yeah?
Got any girlfriends? Preferably older than you.
Yeah, sort of. Thelma's just about 14.
Thelma? What sort of name's that?
Well, Thelma's Catholic.
Oh, brother.
Oh, my God. It's very bad.
sauce in that car.
I just can hardly believe it.
It's true. It's all true. That's him.
Holy cow.
You guys go wait over by the car.
Stop.
Come over here.
What's the matter now?
Look, I can't be seen with you girls in my Cadillac.
Why not?
I don't want to hurt your feelings. But you're all ugly.
She promised.
Okay, okay. Let me think about this for a minute. I'll tell you what. If you girls all sit in the back, we'll cruise to Cologne and back.
What about the A&W?
Forget about the A&W. Now that's the deal. Take it or leave it.
Okay, we'll take it.
Stop and let you out or something.
No, just slow down a little bit.
Ain't seen nothing yet.
Oh my God, it's Lenny McPhee.
Oh no. Is it really?
Who's with them?
Nobody. Shirley's babysitting today.
What you got under there, Butchie boy?
More than you can handle, man.
Oh yeah?
Yeah!
happened? Did we crash?
Listen, you Gort, shut up. Now, the cops are real close. If they hear us, we're going to be in big trouble. So just be good little girls and everything will be fine, all right? Maybe little girls would like something sweet while we sit here to cool off a bit.
Idaho Spud?
What's an Idaho?
The candy bar that makes Idaho famous.
Gee, I've never seen half this candy before.
Let's go for a swim and cool off.
Yeah.
Oh, it's so hot. Yeah.
Anybody want to smoke? What am I saying? You girls are too young to smoke.
Can I have one?
Can I have a drag?
You guys shouldn't smoke his cigarettes. He's crazy.
Tough toenails. I need one. I'm a wreck.
Yeah, me too.
Across the lake.
Yep. I haven't been swimming for a while.
I don't have a bathing suit. Guess I'll have to go skinny dipping.
No.
At last.
Gee, Butch, that's too bad.
I'm going in. Oh,
what? Nice. I'm in.
Come on, let's go. Come on, don't you girls want to have some fun?
Yeah.
Lizzie, don't you dare.
I'm coming to get you. Well, we should be safe now. We can get going. So, who do you think's gonna get to the moon first? Us or the Russians?
What do you mean, us?
Us? The States.
Oh.
Man, I wouldn't go up in a spaceship. What about you? Huh? Would you go?
Yeah, it'd be fun.
Hey, Lizzie. How old are you?
13.
Same age as Jerry Lee Lewis's wife. He married his cousin, you know.
Yeah, we read it in the papers.
Man, that guy is the killer rock and roller. Hey, Sandy, that'd be like you and me getting married.
Fat chance.
Hey, Lizzie, why don't you take your glasses off? Let me see what you look like without them. Hey, you're kind of cute. If you leave them off, you can sit up here in the front seat with me if you like.
Sure.
Climb over the seat, or I'll pull over if you like.
Oh, no. I'll just climb over. Gee, this is a beautiful car. So snazzy.
Glad you like it, Lizzie.
Never gone so fast in all my life.
Yeah?
Yeah, I thought we were gonna die. But, you know, it was sort of fun.
I was sure we were gonna die. I don't know why boys have to go so fast.
Because it's fun, that's why.
Yeah, sort of scary fun. But you know, my mom would kill me if she knew we went that fast.
Yeah, I thought we were all gonna die and I was never gonna live to be a teenager.
Take the
say
wheel.
Cheese.
Don't you just wish we could all go to the dam tonight?
Sandy, better get you home. If old Cherry Top catches us, we're in trouble.
We're already in trouble.
Why?
I was supposed to be home for tea.
Jeez. Get in the car. We're going. Stay here. Hey, I think you're really beautiful.
Kinda young, isn't she, Butch?
Sure.
Rosie, let's go to the washroom.
We just came from there.
Hey, Butch, we aren't finished that race yet. I was just warming up.
Come on.
Bye, Butch.
Bye, Butch.
That's enough for now. Sandra, you are to go to your room and stay there. You left without permission and missed the evening meal.
Dad, I just forgot. That is no excuse. Go to your room.
Sorry about the trouble, Butch, but I had a fabulous time.
Sandra!
No one ever listens to my side of the story. I just forgot. I'm sorry.
And I want your car keys, young man.
But it's my car.
It's your mother's car.
She gave it to me.
You stole it. Look, Butch. I know things aren't very happy at home. I phoned your mother yesterday. She told me what happened. And that you took her car against her wishes. She says you stole it. Now, I wouldn't go as far as that. But still, they are your parents. And they've asked me to keep an eye on you until they arrive tomorrow.
My folks are coming up here, and I'm gonna have to go back?
I'm afraid so, son. The keys, Butch.
Here's your goddamn car keys. I bet they're more worried about that stupid car than they are about me.
John.
I'll try talking to him. I remember your father fighting with his father when he was your age.
Yeah? So what?
Now, Butch, these things are only natural. They've been going on for centuries. But you mustn't let it ruin your life. You must grow to the challenge and meet it, not run away from it.
Some runaway. Can't even run away from it.
I'm very concerned. We all are. It's because we love you that we take these measures you seem to find so objectionable. Now, come on back into the house and I'll let you have a beer. Then I must attend to the evening chores.
Late for rehearsal.
Come on, we'll push.
I'm not pushing, I'm steering.
No way, you push.
I'm steering.
Push. Come on, let's go.
Push.
If I see somebody I want to dance with, I want you to get lost. And don't look for me if you want to ride home. If I want to hang around, that's my business.
Butch, still babysitting?
Hey, Shirley, please, let me explain.
This better be good.
Can we go for a ride and talk? Listen, that girl means nothing to me.
Well, then why were you kissing her?
I was trying to be polite. Listen, it didn't mean anything.
Well, what about me?
I think you're really beautiful.
Oh, don't change the subject.
Hey, Shirley, listen, you know, I'm crazy. As soon as I saw you in the orchard, I was crazy.
Nice dress, Shirley. Is that from Dean's Tots and Teens?
Yeah.
Look, can we cut out somewhere private?
Okay, but just for a while.
Where are you going?
Do me a favor. If you see Lenny, don't tell him you saw me, okay?
Why not?
Please. I'll give you some Little Richard records if you shut up.
Okay. When can I get those records?
I don't know. Maybe next time I see you.
don't know why I kissed her. I don't even like her.
Maybe you think, just because you're from California on vacation, that you can do whatever you please.
Hey, Shirley. Let's be friends. Where are we going?
Let's go to Munson's Mountain. And look at the view.
Sounds nice. I want to be alone with you. Sometimes things get so mixed up, I just feel like I want to explode.
Me too. I mean, when I was a kid, things were so simple, you know?
So nice up here. I wish I didn't have to go.
Well, why don't you get a job and stay?
My folks want me to go back to university. I gotta leave tomorrow.
Well, I wish you didn't have to leave.
He is so adorable.
What did it feel like when he kissed you?
Good. Haven't you ever kissed a guy before?
Just Alan watched that dumb Christmas party, but that doesn't count.
I sure hope I don't have to see Butch again. I'm so embarrassed because I don't think I kissed him right. I used to live in Toronto.
Yeah? Where's that?
Near Detroit.
Snow all year round, huh?
No, actually, the summers are really hot.
You're the first girl that I've...
Yes?
You're the first girl that I've met from Toronto.
Kiddo, what are you doing here?
Nothing.
You seen Cheryl yet?
No.
You must still be babysitting.
Yeah, I guess so.
Welcome to the Teen Town Dominion Day Dance. We're starting things off with a dance contest here, a spa dance. First couple on the floor gets a case of Coke, so let's rip it up here.
Shirley taught me how to jive.
You can jive?
I love to jive.
Well, let's go.
Deep in the heart of Texas. Around the Crystal Bay. All over St. Louis. Down in New Orleans. All the cats want to dance. Sweet little 16. Sweet little 16. She just got to have about a half a
minute. Oh, come on.
No, no, do that. I don't go all the way.
You mean you and Lenny never...
We're saving it until we get married.
Is that all anybody ever thinks about? Getting married. Doesn't anybody just want to have fun anymore?
Quinn.
Well, we're not engaged or anything.
I got a girl back home.
So what? I got Lenny.
Oh, you're a terrible tease. But don't stop. Don't ever stop.
We gotta go.
This is so much fun. I'm never going home.
Can I borrow your pink lipstick?
Did you see Barry Bent?
Okay.
Yeah.
Give me some clear nail polish. I gotta run.
Where'd you turn?
In my stocking. You are so immature.
Where did that cute American guy go? I think he left with Sherry Darling. Uh-oh.
Go for a little walk. Then we'll go right back to the dance.
I wish I could stay here.
Yeah. Me too. I think I'm really gonna miss you, Shirley. We could have been the most.
Today can try a man's patience. Dreadful music all the time.
Oh, I'm sure she's a good girl, Major.
Well, she better be.
Well, maybe she's out in the parking lot.
My God.
Wally, if you don't stop yakking, we'll never get to the dance.
If he asks, if you're all alone.
Sandy, the Major's in town. He's looking for you.
Yeah, and he's dancing with horny Gladys Rutherford. She made a beeline for him as soon as she saw his wife wasn't there.
She's still much too young.
Oh, dear Major. I remember when you were younger.
Do you? Lovely night for a dance.
It's going to be fireworks later on.
It's a nice night.
Yeah, I like the sound of the waves on the beach. Did you ever see the movie Rebel Without a Cause?
No, hasn't come to town yet.
I'll tell you what. If you ever make it down to California, I'll take you to the movies.
Chevrolet.
That's disgusting that that would happen.
Scooty.
Hey, guys, what's shaking?
Hey, Scooty.
Hey, Len. Looking for your girl?
Yeah, maybe. I think I saw her strolling along the beach with that American guy. Butch?
Yeah.
Thank you, thank you. Now, the ladies.
It's nearly time for the fireworks.
Yes, and I must locate Sandra.
I'll distract him.
Oh, Major Wilcox, what a surprise. Are you looking for the fireworks?
No, I'm looking for Sandra. I don't suppose you've seen her, have you?
Yeah, over there.
Well, are you quite sure? I just came from there.
In the ladies' room.
Oh. Well, if you see her again, please tell her she's got a lot of explaining to do.
Gee, this is getting exciting. You crazy? How are we supposed to get home? When are we supposed to get home? What if I get caught?
We better go now. If Lenny ever sees me with you, oh my God. Lenny, we just went for a walk.
Take that slimy jacket off, Cheryl.
Hey, wait a minute. Where I come from, you don't talk to chicks like that.
Yeah? Is that so? Why don't you go back to wherever it is you came from, you no good lazy bum? All you're doing here is sticking your nose in other people's business. Come on, Cheryl.
Don't fight, please. Don't fight.
Stay out of it.
You leave her alone.
No, you leave her alone!
Lenny, please. This is so embarrassing.
Yeah. What's your reputation, Cheryl? Mine. I used to think you were okay. But you're just some tough punk in a fancy car trying to pick up chicks.
That's not it at all.
Yeah, it's probably his mummy's car anyway. Is that big hunk of metal mummy's car, Butcher Boy, huh?
Yeah, it's better than that junkyard special you try to drive, Mr.
Don't get
Hotshot.
Smart with me!
Come on, Bruce, let's go.
No, that's okay. You want to fight? All right, I'll fight. I'll take you. Come on, bud. Yelling at guys like you make me sick trying to steal my girl.
Yeah, you can't steal something if it's free.
Yeah. Come on, let him drop an hand on him.
Ah, Butch, there you are. Lenny?
Yes, sir.
I hope you'll be up bright and early tomorrow for the parade.
Yes, sir. I was just on my way home, sir.
Glad to hear it. Butch, you look a mess. Now, come along.
I want to go.
What the hell are you trying to prove?
I was
just coming up here and getting into fights.
I wasn't looking for trouble. I just wanted to have a good time.
Ah, good time. What about decency and responsibility?
I don't know.
Of course you don't know. I want you back at the ranch immediately. So don't try any more of your stupid chunks tonight. You've done enough damage already. Now to find my wretched daughter. Excuse me, I'm looking for my daughter. Sandra? Evening.
radio.
Can I ride in the front seat now?
Where did you come from? Boy, are we gonna get it.
Yeah, I know. Let's run away from home.
You and me?
I'm serious.
Got any money?
No. Don't you?
No.
You ever wonder about the stars?
Yeah, as often as I can.
Well, do you think heaven is inside the universe or just outside the universe?
Well, myself, I don't think it's anywhere. No one can prove to me there is a heaven. As far as I can figure it out, when you're dead, it's just like you're asleep. But you don't dream. You never wake up. Nothing happens. And that's it. Wham. Nothing.
Maybe. But I think people's spirits leave their bodies and float around the sky. In fact, I think it's probably getting a little crowded up there, and I wonder if the universe can sort of expand, take in everybody.
I won't be cremated.
But you said nothing happens to you after you're dead, so what do you care?
I don't know. It just gives me the creeps, that's for sure.
Drive. Let's just drive.
Out of gas.
Oh, brother.
Let's start walking.
Okay.
Walking. It takes so long to get anywhere. Don't tell me you're crying. What's the matter now? You scared of your dad?
A little. It's more than that. Sorry to say it. I think I'm crazy. Promise you won't laugh if I tell you.
Promise. What is it?
Well, it's just we've had so much fun. Now it's all over.
Hey, relax, kid. You're just starting out. It'll be lots of fun for you. Being a teenager is the best time of your life. Look at me.
Yeah, look at you. Out of gas, walking along a dirt road with the ugly 12-year-old.
Hey, who says you're ugly?
You, you creep.
Yeah, well, you're not beautiful.
Say that one more time and I'll kill you.
No, no, don't. Now, don't fight with chicks. Okay, okay. You're not ugly.
Gee, Butch, that's sweet of you. You really mean that?
Well, it's kind of dark out here tonight. Oh, just kidding. Just joking, honest. Well, kid, here's looking at you.
Yeah? You go first.
Huh? You go first. He's your father.
Yeah, well, you're the boy.
Well, you're the daughter.
Well, you're still the boy.
Yeah, well, you're the girl.
Well, you're older.
did you learn to kiss like that? Okay, now, you going first.
You going first.
Oh, go on.
No, I'm not going first.
Get to your room, young lady, this instant.
Let's go together.
Good idea.
Give me your car keys right now. I'm very disappointed in you.
Sorry, sir. We just went into
It's too late for apologies. This type of behavior is simply not acceptable. She is only 12 years old.
Yeah, but she's the one...
No buts, young man. Get to your room. I'm tired of this kind of thing.
Kane, wait a minute.
I'll meet you at the ranch gate.
Sandra, get back inside. You have work to do.
Yeah, I'm coming.
You're crazy. You're gonna get in trouble.
You sure this is all you can lend me?
I got $5 from Danny.
Well, thanks. I'll pay you both back after I get a job. You can have Bimbo the Budgie. Give Danny my records. Don't give Eddie anything. Oh, maybe...
Sandra, you can come out now. I'll need some help with tea. Your father should be back any moment from the parade.
I'm coming.
Butch! Butch, baby!
Oh, honey, you never should have taken Mommy's car.
Oh, yeah, the girl, Mary Kay, she's all right. She was just a little late, that's all. Nothing to worry about.
So you see, sweetheart, everything's all right now, and you can come home with us.
That's right, son. We come to bring you home.
What if I don't want to come? What if I like it up here or something?
Don't be ridiculous, Butch. Look, you don't have to marry the girl anymore. You can come home with us now, where you belong. My car is a mess. What the hell have you been doing, Butch?
Never mind that now. We got our boy back, safe and sound.
Why never mind that now, Al? After we've traveled
Hello.
All this way
There's
and that
Kitty.
Long... Good to see you.
Hi, Kitty.
Hello, Dolly. How are you, dear?
Fine. How are you doing? Fine. You just arrived.
Oh, good.
How are you, Kitty? Good to see you. What's it been, 10 years?
10 years, I suppose. Yeah, something like that.
I sure hope our boy hasn't been too much trouble to you.
Oh, not at all, not at all. It was nothing, really. It's just unfortunate things didn't turn out a little bit better.
Yeah.
Kitty, do you drive on that awful road?
Nearly every day.
I don't know how you do it. I was simply terrified. I mean, what if another car is coming the other way or something? I mean, it's so skinny.
Well, you just pull over and let them pass by.
Did you hear that, Al? Oh, Kitty, you're a braver girl than I'd ever be, I'll tell you that. Boy, I would never want to...
Excuse us for a moment. Dolly, why don't you just...
Al, I don't like it when you talk that way to me.
Dolly?
Especially in front of other people.
Dolly, this is family.
I don't care who it is,
Al. Why don't we go and have a nice cup of tea? It's been a long drive, and I'm sure you're ready for a good cup of tea. Come on, girl.
Tea? Don't these people drink coffee?
Dolly?
Don't mind me, anyone.
You coming in, Butch boy?
Nah.
Come on, honey.
Well, shoot yourself.
So those are your folks, eh?
Don't rub it in.
What a view. Boy, oh boy. What a view. Dolly, can you see this view?
You get much snow here?
Only when it's cold. Tea, Dolly?
Oh, sure, thanks. I love tea.
What's a place like this worth anyway, John?
Depends on who's buying.
Okay, say it's a guy like me who's buying. Now, what's it worth?
You always have to put a price tag on things.
Sandra, would you take the cake and pass it to the children, please?
Oh, thanks, Jenny.
Some cake, Aunt Dub?
Sure. Thanks, sweetie. What's diet if you can't eat?
Shut up.
How old are you? You're Ruth?
No, I'm Sandy. I'm 13.
Oh, Sandra. You are 12.
I was 18 when I married Al.
Great spot for a resort. You ever thought of turning this into a swanky resort, Joan?
My butch will be 18 in the spring.
Takes a lot of capital. Pretty risky business.
Oh, John, I know a lot of guys who'd come up here away from it all if it was fixed up a bit.
You know, Al, I'd like to be going soon. I don't want to be on that road in the dark.
Dolly, after we have a cup of tea.
Okay, Al, but it's getting late.
Kit, you know, you really ought to sell this place you got here and move to the States. You're wasting your time up here. Why, there's so much money down there for a guy like John.
Bye, Bimbo. Bye, Elvis.
I'm serious.
Coming, Dolly.
Butch, there'll always be a bed for you here, son. Business is aside, we're still family.
Thank you, sir.
Now, please, just try and stay out of trouble.
Aunt Kitty, could you do me a favor? Could you make sure Sandra gets this?
She's too young. Yes, I'll give it to her. Now, be sensible.
The gate there for me, Ruthie?
Sandy. I'm Sandy. Where's Butch?
Ah, he'll be along. Nice seeing you again, Ruthie. You all come down and see us sometime now, you hear?
Stop! Hey, wait! Hey, all my stuff!
Did you see Butch leave?
Yes, I saw Butch leave.
Sandra, as you get older, you'll see. Boys are like buses.
If you miss one, another one will be along before you know it.
I doubt it.
Butch left this for you. Well, I have to go into town for a dress rehearsal. Would you like to come?
Is Barry Bent going to be there?
Yes.
Okay, sure.
There's a bluebird on your windowsill. There's a rainbow in your sky. There are happy thoughts your heart to fill. Dear enough to make you cry.
I don't recall ever seeing my American cousin again after that. Oh, we still got their wonderful shiny Christmas cards, even after Al and Dolly got divorced and Dad sold the ranch and Lenny and Shirley got married. Somehow, my dreams about a Prince Charming coming to rescue me were badly battered. I never gave up planning my escape, though. Funny, I used to think about Butch whenever I opened the gate. I was in such a hurry to get off the ranch. Then when we sold it, I missed it more than I ever would have thought possible. My mom gave a wonderful performance as Hedda Gabler, and she even gave me some batteries for Butch's transistor when I finally turned 13. And she was right about the boys, too.
You wanna